Think of virtual private servers and physical servers and you know, manage scripts to keep all that stuff working. High availability clustering is something that I think is just totally awesome. So instead of having one machine, you have just like rows of parallel machines. Like this cluster of 12 machines does my MySQL, and this cluster of 4 machines does my web server. And you know, there are a million articles you can read about high availability clustering. Super fun, super nerdy. Spin a bunch of VPS instances on like Vulture or something for cheap, and have fun making each one do something specific. And then realize you wasted like a weekend. So, self-hosting is another great thing to do. It's super educational. I used to run archives for a podcast out of Illinois under my desk for years, and one power supply died, but we didn't want all the downtime, so we just ran another power supply through the back of the computer, picked everything up, and it was a Frankenstein box that you had to, you know, do an incantation to keep running. I had worked under my desk for years, and I learned an awful lot doing it, and I would never do it again because it was frustrating. And you have so many points of failure if you're going to host it yourself, right? If your power goes out, if your neighbors, you know, put in sprinklers and cuts your internet connection, if your wife unplugs it to vacuum the office, which happened to me. So here's some third-party tools. If you found the right host, and they have everything you need, except for one blank feature, right? There's a plugin, more than likely. It's WordPress. Backups, Vaultpress is fast, works great on shared hosting because they put the load on their end and not on the server end. But there's also backup running duplicator. For staging, ManageWP, a WordCamp sponsor, can spin up like a complete duplicate instance of your site. If you're trying to change something really weird, give them a shot. Desktop server, also WordCamp sponsor. The cool thing they do is like run it local. So you don't have to be really technical. Take your site, run it locally on your laptop, and make the changes you need. And they've got like a one-click deploy back to the live site. It's pretty cool. WP Stagecoach is another one that I've tried. I want to say they're about $7 a month. But they do the process of saying, well, I want to stage this site. They'll create a VPS for you. They'll install WordPress on it. They'll put the subdomain on it and figure out from there, you know, play around, break stuff where your customers aren't going to see it. Caching, I recommend, I actually recommend using any of that. But WP Supercache is one, I think I tried it yesterday for the first time. Maybe it was WP Rocket. W3TC, there was an interesting article not too long ago on WP Tavern about them, and they've had some issues recently, although I haven't experienced any of that, but it seems like support's kind of a problem with W3TC, although they were kind of a de facto standard for a bit. So, if you're really interested in hosting, I went through a lot of stuff real quick. Grab these slides on my website, binarygary.com. Jeff Mattson used to work for, I think, Liquid Web, who's here. He's fantastic. Great guy to follow online. Mika Epstein works for DreamHost. She also does, is like the gatekeeper for the plugin repository. So if it's WordPress, I mean, it's like, she's like the matrix man, just plug into her head. She did a presentation at WordCamp Europe that I really enjoyed watching. Brian Kopsgaard does a website called, is it Postmaster? I don't know what it's called. But he has a podcast called Postmaster Draft Podcast, and they just, in the last like month and a half, covered hosting. If you're really interested in some of that soap opera type conversation, check that podcast out. Kevin Ohashi does an annual benchmark on WordPress hosting. If it's technical you're after, check that link out. I've actually used that the last 2 or 3 years when I'm looking for a host for a site and referred to some of the testing he's done, and generally been really happy. I found that his testing really is pretty similar to real world performance on a lot of the hosts he looks at. And he just does some really cool, really technical WordPress stuff. So we have about 3 minutes and 40 seconds, I guess.